Prince Harry won't stand for living in LA forever, Roy being led on Meghan's path. Prince Harry will not be able to stand being in Los Angeles forever, despite his blinding love for Meghan Markle, a former royal family insider has warned. Speaking to ITV's Lorraine, a former royal butler, Paul Burrell, said Prince Harry will not be happy in Los Angeles forever, as he warned the Duke of Sussex will soon realize he's totally besotted by Meghan Markle and will miss his friends and family in the UK. Mr. Burrell said, "He's married to this woman who has ideas of her own. He's so besotted by her, he's totally in love with her that she can't do anything wrong. So now he's being led along her path. But it won't always be that way. I personally cannot see Harry happy in Los Angeles. All his friends, his family, and his culture are back here in England. He's not going to stand that forever." Meghan and Harry moved to America earlier this year when they announced they would no longer be working members of the royal family. This Sunday, the pair will join forces with Nobel Peace Prize Malala Yousafzai, the outspoken advocate for girls' right to an education, and discuss the invisible barriers keeping millions of young women out of school. The trio's conversation will be live-streamed through YouTube and the Malala's fund's social media channels. Meghan, Harry, and Ms. Yousafzai's attention will be on why it's essential that we champion every girl's right to learn, according to Bazaar.com. The topic of education for girls is not new to Meghan. Much of the Duchess of Sussex's humanitarian work before meeting Prince Harry was focused on the female empowerment and bringing girls into education. In 2016, the then soap star traveled to RADA to highlight the importance of providing adequate bathrooms in schools, as they could make the difference between girls and women getting an education or not. In March 2017, months before she and Harry announced the engagement to the world, Meghan also wrote an op-ed for Time magazine focused on the stigma around menstruation and how the lack of access to proper sanitation directly inhibits young women from pursuing an education. Meghan could continue this battle as a member of the royal family also thanks to the fact that she becomes a patron of the Association of Commonwealth University, ACU. During her first tour abroad, in the late summer of 2018, Meghan delivered an impassioned speech in which she highlighted the struggles many women face to enter higher education. During the Successful Sussex tour to South Africa, Meghan's attention was once again on female empowerment and opening the path to education to girls. Speaking at the University of Johannesburg, before announcing on behalf of ACU three new grants for women's education in South Africa, Meghan said, "When a woman is empowered, it changes absolutely everything in the community. Sometimes access to education can seem so big, you wonder where to even begin. So you begin with one student or one school. You simply begin, and that's when we see change." Meghan and Prince Harry had already pledged their support to the fight for equal access to education around the world after starting their post-royal lives in April.